In this episode, I'm going to take my CNC Labs Mill One and convert it into a circuit board cutter. I'll show you all the steps I did to make this to add it to my electronics workbench to give me a complete setup. This episode is brought to you by the generous donations of my Patreon supporters. The CNC Mill One has this plastic base. That's what you work from, and then you can clamp your material or double-sided stick tape to it. I just clamped a piece of wood from my very first project. And then I decided to use that same piece of wood and make it more permanent. So I cut it to the exact same size of that plastic base. And then I used the CNC Mill One to drill a hole in each corner, all the way through the wood and into the plastic. And then I used a 1.5-inch quarter 20 bolt, put that through the hole, and then a nut underneath, and then tighten this guy up. And I did this at all four corners. So I just used a wrench and a ratchet and tighten this guy down until the head of the bolt was exactly flush with the top of the wood. Now I did crush the wood a little bit in the corner, but it really doesn't matter. I made it so it was flush, and now I needed to cut a perfectly flat surface. So I went to Easel, brought in this block, and set it to a 2mm cut with a complete fill. And then I let it just router this guy out so I knew I'd have a perfectly flat base in order to cut my circuit boards. And here is a circuit board. It's a one-sided. It's got copper on one side and a fiberglass material on the other. So I just want to cut through just the top layer of that copper to form my circuit board. So I used double-sided sticky tape on the back and stuck it down to that flat area. Now for the circuit board, I like to use ExpressPCB. This is a software I use. They've got a plus version. I use the classic version. It's been around for over 20 years. I'm so familiar with it. But it doesn't output Gerber files directly. You can get them if you join their membership or buy it separately, but that's after you order a board. So I wanted to see if I could just screen capture a board layout. So here's a simple board layout that I had created. And I just screen captured that circuit as an individual image. And then I went to Easel to see if this would work, is import it as a image to trace. So I imported that image and then I set the threshold very low and it looked great. This is what I was looking for. So then I did trace outline and I got the outlines of what I wanted to cut. So this was looking really good. And here it is imported into Easel. Now I had to resize this to the exact size. It didn't do that. But I set it to a 0.9mm depth of cut. Very, very fine. And then on the inside. And then for the holes, I did those as a fill. So it would just cut out an area. I'm going to drill these holes later on my drill press. So I just needed a marker. So once I had that set, I generated a preview. And look, you can see it's cutting out the copper island. It's exactly what I wanted. I made a Z probe with my meter. I clipped to the bolt and then to the bit, and I lowered it until the meter told me they were just touching. And then I was ready to send the file. I let the Easel software control the CNC Mill One, and I could see right away this thing was cutting perfectly. I had the height set just right. It took a couple passes around and made a perfect little island. So I just let this thing continue to cut, and here's kind of a time lapse. It cut it so perfectly even because I had milled that board. I was really happy with the results I was getting. And here are the results. You can see if you look real close, it cut through that copper perfectly. There were no bridges, no shorts. This thing worked great. So now I just needed to drill the holes. Now I could have done that with the mill, but it's just as easy to do it on my drill press. And because I gouged out those holes, the bit just fell right into place. And after I was done with this, I had my board ready to be soldered together. But before that, I wanted to cut it out to the actual size. So I went to the bandsaw, and this stuff cuts pretty easy on my bandsaw. So I cut out along those edges that the CNC Mill One had cut to tell me the size of the board. And there's the result, actual size. And the final step, insert the components, bend over the leads, and solder them all in place. This is bare copper, but I had sanded the board, so I was getting really good flow. And because the channels were cut good, I was getting no shorts or bridging. And once I applied power, it started working. This is a flashing back and forth train crossing type circuit. So it worked perfectly. Now I have a complete electronics work area, from design, solder, and test area to 3D print design and printing to the CNC circuit board cutter and bezels if I wanted, along with the components and test equipment. From one end to the other and back again, I have a complete electronics prototype lab right here in my workshop. If you want to see more projects like this, let me know in the comments below. If you want to check out some of the other projects, check out these videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, $1 a month to Patreon. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. That's it. I'll see you next time.